Graph theory is useful for describing relationships. One common type of relationship is a hierarchy. Organization flowcharts, sorting diagrams, succession plans. Consider a hierarchy. One important feature of a hierarchy is that there are no cycles. We define a tree is a connected graph with no cycles. Let's see where this takes us. Suppose G is a tree. Since it's connected, there's a path between any two vertices, U and V. Could there be a second path? If there was, we could form a cycle. But trees don't have cycles, and so, suppose G is a tree, then between any two vertices, there is a unique path. One way to really understand mathematics is to follow every possible consequence of a result. We can do so as follows. Suppose we start with the conditional if A, then B. We can link this to a conditional if B, then C, which we can then link to a conditional if C, then D. How far can we go? So the theorem we just proved concluded that between any two vertices in a graph, there is a unique path. So suppose that in a graph G with n vertices, there is a unique path between any two points. Then we know G has no cycles, because again, if there's a second path, there must be a cycle. And because there is a path, G is connected. And we know that a connected graph with n vertices has to have at least n minus 1 edges. So we know our graph has n minus 1 edges. It could have more edges, but we know it has n minus 1 edges. And consequently, if there is a unique path between any two points, G has n minus 1 edges and no cycles. Now, it's important to notice that while we proved that G has n minus 1 edges and no cycles, we did not prove that G is connected. So, what if G only had n minus 1 edges and no cycles, and we didn't know whether or not it was connected? Well, we actually proved something about this. We do know that G is connected. But if G is connected with n minus 1 edges, we know something about that as well. Adding one edge introduces exactly one cycle. And again, let's start with our consequent. G is a graph with n vertices and n minus 1 edges, and suppose that adding one edge introduces one cycle. And again, we don't know at this point if G is connected, so let's consider two vertices, U and V. If we add an edge between them, we create a cycle. But this means that without the edge, a path had to exist between U and V. So the original graph had to be connected, and we have. Suppose G is a graph with n vertices and n minus 1 edges. If adding an edge produces a cycle, then G is a connected graph with n minus 1 edges. So again, starting with our consequent, G is a connected graph with n minus 1 edges, then we know that G is connected and every edge is a bridge. And since every edge is a bridge, the graph can have no cycles. So G is a connected graph with no cycles, which means that G is a tree, giving us a theorem, which puts us right back at our starting point. Now we've produced a sequence of conditionals, if A, then B, if B, then C, if C, then D, and so on, where the last conditional takes us back to our starting point, if Z, then A. And what this means is that we can start with any statement and conclude any other statement. It's almost as if there's a graph here. So, for example, suppose that G is a graph with n vertices. Let's prove that if G has n minus 1 edges and no cycles, then there is a unique path between any two vertices. So, remember, we can always assume the antecedent, the if portion. So, suppose G has n minus 1 edges and no cycles, we know G is connected. But since G is a connected graph with n minus 1 edges, every edge in G is a bridge. And if every edge in a connected graph is a bridge, then G is a tree. But if G is a tree, there is a unique path between any two vertices.